Hey, everybody, this is Pastor Patrick. This is Resurrection Sunday. It's beautiful out there. I mean, look at the sunrise right behind me. Listen, I'm getting ready to go to church, but I have a short word for you, something that I believe will just put something in your mind. All right, come with me to Mark chapter 16. There's something that the Spirit of God just pointed it out to me, and I want to show it to you and let you think about something. Mark 16. We see something here that's very interesting. For the sake of time, and I'm going to be very quick because I got to run to church. Verse 16:5. Listen to this. When they were entering the tomb, they saw a young man. Okay, I'm holding my Bible reading as always from the Amplified Bible. When they were entering the tomb, they saw a young man sitting on the right, wearing a long, steadily white robe, all right? And they were amazed and bewildered. And he asked them, do not be afraid. You are looking for Jesus, the Nazarene, who was crucified. He has risen. Glory be to God. He is risen, all right? He is not here. He says, he is not here. Look at the place where they laid him. Verse 7 says, this is the point I want to make to you. Watch this. He says, but go tell his disciples and Peter. He's going ahead of you to Galilee. You will see him there just as he told you. And I'm thinking, he says, go and tell the disciples and Peter. I thought Peter was part of the disciples. As a matter of fact, Peter's supposed to be the head of the disciples, if you will. He is the one always running his mouth. God, I love you and all that. And then the Spirit of God says, you are wondering why he said, tell the disciples and Peter, singling Peter out. There's a reason. And that reason we can find out in chapter 14, verse 28. Look at that quickly with me. Chapter 14. Of Mark, okay, Mark chapter 14, verse 28. Look at that very quickly. And it says, but after I have been raised, listen to that. He says, Jesus talking here. He says, after I have been raised from the dead, I will go ahead of you to Galilee. Verse 29. This is where the answer is. He says, but Peter said to him, I quote Peter, even if they all fall away and desert you, ashamed and afraid of being associated with you, yet I will not do so. Beloved, you know that was not the case with Peter. You know, when the rubber met the road, Peter said, I don't even know this guy. As far as the Bible tells you and I that people who saw Peter with Jesus were saying that, hey, Peter, you are one of them. Peter came to a point where he started even cursing them. I don't know this guy. Leave me alone. Beloved, I don't know if you have turned your back against him. Today, Jesus is resurrected. We are celebrating over 2,000 years ago. The power of resurrection is still alive. Wherever you are, if you have turned your back against him, it is time for you to think about it. Go back to him. I often say this. It doesn't matter how bad the situation is. It doesn't matter how bad you find yourself. Every second and every time you have the opportunity to run back to Jesus. Peter says, I don't know him. Maybe you have also denied him before, but you have the time now. Listen, I'm ready to go to church now. Happy Resurrected Sunday. I'll see you same time. If Jesus don't, as always, if he doesn't show up tonight, tomorrow we're going to be with each other. All right? Enjoy and happy Resurrected Sunday to you. God bless you. Love you. You don't have no trouble. As always, all you need is your faith in God. And in all thy getting, get understanding. God bless you. Love you. Happy Sunday.